workers are cranking out precision machine parts at the Como manufacturing plant in Lakewood, New Jersey.
We're in the process of building some moving table machines here. These are
2 years ago, this work was done by Chinese laborers in the city of Nanjing. Today, production and jobs have moved back to the United States.
Hi guys, how are you? Nice to meet you.
More than 50 people are now employed here, many of whom were unemployed a few years back.
I said, I need to go get this product back here because that's what our workforce wants, that's what the customers want.
One big reason, quality control. Customers of Como's metal and wood cutting machines perceive products made in China as cheap. And while Chinese labor is less expensive than in the U.S.,
well, I find that I hire one skilled mechanical assembler or electrical assembler here, I would probably need five over in China. I mean, that's the skill difference.
The bottom line?
We have become more profitable, I think, because of this move.
Como is not the only manufacturer bringing jobs back to the U.S. As wages in low-cost factory centers rise, the cost benefit of outsourcing is fading fast. Apple says it will make more computers here, and Walmart is committed to stocking more American-made products.
The renaissance is definitely there. America is now, I think, a more attractive place to manufacture, partly because I think the dollar is at a more appropriate level, and also because we've got a lot of cheap energy coming online.
A renaissance maybe, but times have changed.
50 years ago, manufacturing was the pathway to the middle class for many Americans. Even if you didn't have much of an education, if you were highly motivated and smart, you could succeed. But experts say the future of manufacturing in America may look very different.
A lot of the jobs that are basically tied to manufacturing now are sort of white-collar jobs, if you like, are service sector jobs rather than the factory floor jobs.
Challenges remain, but with millions still out of work, any jobs returning to the U.S. can make a big difference for communities.
He came into the lobby. He was a veteran of World War II from Iwo Jima, and he just wanted to come and shake my hand and thank me for bringing manufacturing back to the United States.
The American flag is proudly on display again at Como. Many in the U.S. hope that it's here to stay. Maggie Lake, CNN, New York.